There he searched so hard for the name of his son, etched upon a cold black shiny stone. Tears filled his eyes as he stood there crying, for until this day he'd never felt so all alone.
So precious. no fortune or fame, no dignitaries calling out my name, no invitations from the presidential staff. But this I know for sure, there's one thing I do have. I got victory,
I've got victory,
I've got victory,
I've got victory,
I've got victory. Been running to and fro, trying to sneak up on me, to steal away my soul. Well, I know I won the battle when they hung Jesus on the cross. So if I won the battle, devil, I know that you have lost. I got victory,
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 I got
victory,
I
got victory,
I got victory,
I got victory,
I got victory.
Trouble and you don't know what to do, just lift your hands to Jesus. I know he'll see you through. He's never lost a battle and I know he never will. He won it all for you and me when he died upon that hill. I got victory,
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 I got victory.
Teenagers out driving, 16-year-old was driving the vehicle, and they cited the speed, Mr. Jackie, and they lost control. I don't know if it was a boy or a girl, but they lost control of the vehicle, and they started to switch lanes. And in Brandon, they switched lanes. When they did, they lost control of the vehicle. They hit a curb, and the curb threw them in the air, and it caused them to roll over and flip, and it killed them. The 16-year-old, two 17-year-old, and the 14-year-old's in the hospital fighting for her life. And I think it was all girls. I'm thinking that. Amen. But I'm supposed to walk blind, but they're not going to be walking blind. But remember their families. I don't know who they are, but I come across that, amen, on the news. Amen, there. And we don't know. We don't know what, you know, the Bible said, you know, no matter what age, amen, it's your time to go, you're going to go. Amen. But remember those families, amen, because I know they're hurting this morning, the day, amen, they're grieving. Remember the Aldrich family, Michael Aldrich family, amen, Andy Hoskins, amen, and the children, amen, their daddy passed away last night also, amen, got sick 13 days ago, and then he's gone to be with Jesus. Amen. So, but remember that family in your prayers tonight. Amen. God be with them. Also, remember the girl that I told you about this morning, 16-year-old here in Glasgow, Mackenzie. Lane, her family. Amen. Remember them. Amen. I don't know the girl. Amen. But God just laid her on my heart as I read that yesterday. God laid it on my heart. Amen. That, you know, that age limit, Sister Jackie, don't matter, amen, when it's time, you're going to go, amen, but remember that family also, amen, Wednesday will be her funeral, amen, but just remember that family, amen, that God will strengthen them and God will help them. Also remember Brother Jackie Stamps tonight, you know, Sister Pat, I know she's been posting a lot of stuff more here on Facebook, amen, but I actually remember him. Also remember, Sister Darlene's sister, Lori Webb, amen. She was, boy, she's really, amen, on that, sir. She's up there on there and put comments on the video this morning, amen. And she needs prayer. She'll be here Easter Sunday, amen. Darlene's done hit her up, boy. She done told her what she had to bring and all this, and boy, she brings what she told her to bring, man. It's gonna be so good. Amen. But remember her, amen, and her husband. Amen. They're going to be here, amen, Easter Sunday. And I'm excited about that. Amen. Remember Darlene's brother, Brian. Amen. He's going to be here Sunday. Easter Sunday. That's going to be great. Amen. I'm just waiting, Sister Jackie. Amen. Been praying, amen, people, amen, to get saved. Amen. Not only them, but her family. All her family's going to be here. Amen. I'm looking forward to the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Hey, we don't know who all is going to show up Easter Sunday. But listen, if we have to give up some seats, we'll give up some seats. Amen. We have to. We'll move that thing out back there. We'll put something back here. Amen. We have to. We'll put shut the furnace off back there. We'll put a bench back there. Somebody can sit down back there. But we'll make room. Amen. We'll lower scooter. We can move it out. We can have Michael just drive it on in here, which means it. Amen. We can put it over yonder. Amen. We put 6 years right here. Amen. But I'm looking for a tear down. Amen. I'm looking for the Holy Ghost to move. Amen. So remember that. Remember that service. I ask you to remember Brother Randall and Sister Tasha. Amen. Weaver. In your prayers. Amen. They're battling some things now. Amen. But God knows. Amen. So I ask you to remember them. Also remember Brother Jonathan Leonard and Tammy Leonard up in Ohio. Amen. They're facing some things right now also. Sister Darlene.
Remember more. She goes back to Dr. Rudder tomorrow afternoon. And
it's results from my test I did.
That God has still got it.
God's got it. Yes, amen. I've got to say that this morning. But, yeah, I definitely remember her. Amen. I think the 28th is they're going to have a special service.
It's April 8th.
Anybody else tonight? Yes, amen. Remember those on TikTok, dear God. Tonight, also remember those on Big Old Live. Amen. Tonight, I've been just overflowing with the people, amen, that's watching. Amen. On TikTok and Big Old Live and Facebook Live. We have over 90-some views on this morning on the morning service, but probably more than that by now. But a lot of people get back on there and watch us after we go off. Amen, and they watch us. And there's some that watch us that don't click onto our videos, but they sit and watch us. Amen. So we appreciate those. Amen. We appreciate all y'all. Amen. I want you to be praying for Brother Darrell and Sister Frances and Sister Carly Pope and Marjorie Burke and Judy McCarty and their sister Lynn. Amen. And Paul and Silas, the two little boys. Amen. That God will be with them out there in California. That God will move in their behalf. Amen. We want to tell that Sister Gloria Stetson down in Houston, Texas. Amen. Down there in Texas. Amen. She watches our services when she can. Amen. She's got some other things that's going on in her body. Amen. Not just on her legs. She just wants the Lord to hurry up and touch her legs and stuff. Amen. But she's got some other issues in her body, so she's asking the church to pray for her. Amen. So we still remember her. Remember Brother Lord and Sister Elizabeth Wintringer. Amen. In your prayers.
Kathy said that. She has a praise report to put on here. Said Brother Lauren got a better trucking job with benefits, and they even pay for hotel stay. And she said that was a praise report for them, and she said, remember her, she's in pain.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. That's what we pray for. Amen.
Also, I wanted to tell you, we met a black couple while we was eating today. She was a teacher at WKU, but they're going to come visit sometime.
Amen. All right. Praise the Lord. Amen. Anybody on live stream, Brother Lee? Anybody else got a prayer request?
Remember one of the grandkids.
Yeah, remember
Audrey,
Ryan, and Valerie's little girl. Amen. She's got was running a fever and had an ear infection, and now she's got the diarrhea throwing up. Amen. Her temperature's 95. Amen. So remember her. Amen. That God will touch her. So,
I meant to say, I got a message today from my cousin asking for prayer for his older sister. Said she's got fluid buildup around the heart and her lungs, and they got her in ICU.
Yes, amen. Remember that. Also remember Brother Timmy Brown and Sister Tammy. Amen. Sister Tammy, amen. The fluid together up around her heart. So she has to go have it pumped off. Amen. I hadn't heard from them lately. Amen. But remember them in prayer. Yes, amen. Also remember Sister Jenny Wilson. Amen. They got approved. Amen. Down in Atlanta, Georgia. They're going to be going this week. I don't know what day they're leaving this week. Amen. To go there, but pray for them. That God give them a safe trip, and they get down there and they can check her out and see what's going on with her. Amen. Because it don't hurt to have a second opinion. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We got several people around Glasgow that watches our TikTok. Amen. And they've been interested in the church. So pray that God just get a hold of their hearts and they'll just come.
Amen. Can you remember Peyton in prayer
too? Yes, Peyton. Amen. Yes, remember Peyton. I hadn't heard how his test results came back. Amen. But remember them. Remember Ray and Linda. Also remember Brother Kevin Payne. Amen. He's got some issues in his body. Amen. For God to touch him. Amen. So pray that God will touch him. Amen. And touch his body. Brother Morris, amen. God's got it. Amen. The doctor's done had Brother Morris gone on time, but Morris is still here. Amen. God's not done with Brother Morris. Amen.
That's right, amen.
God's got missing chaplain back here last Sunday. Amen. But that's all right. I'm going to catch him one day and get doing it. Amen. Sister Darlene, now she's holding, she's saying, you're going to send away from me because I've got to get out and move. Amen. So I'm just waiting for that to happen too. Amen. Sister Jackie's going to cut a shine here before it's over with. I'm telling you. You say, what are you talking about, Brother Miller? I believe the Holy Ghost is going to fall on this place. And people are just going to start, boy, when them kids start coming in here, Sister Jackie's going to lose it. I'm just going to tell you. Amen. I'm looking forward to it. How many believe that God's going to bless us with our promise in the Lord? Sister Darlene, I believe it's going to play. I passed by, they got a sign out there. Amen. They're fixing to move into their promise. Amen. They're fixing to move into their new sanctuary. Well, Brother Miller, you ain't lost faith. No, I ain't lost faith. Amen. I know, amen, what God showed me. Amen, Sister Jackie, and I'm holding on to it. Amen. Praise the Lord. Pray for that. Amen, tonight. We're still praying, Sister Linda.
Yep.
Amen. We're still praying. Get good results. Amen. Anybody else tonight?
Just still remember
Linda's prayer. Yes. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Remember Brother Michael? Amen. He's been doing what I told him to ask the Lord, what the Lord wanted him to do. Amen. So Brother Michael has been doing what God has showed him to do. Amen. What God tells you to do, what plates to push back, and He tells you to push all the plates back, push them back. Amen. Don't settle for the crumbs. Amen. But remember the whole church. Amen. Pray for all the church family. Amen. We're all one family. Remember Sister Teresa's daughter. Amen. Another infection has come in her body. They don't know what it is. Amen. So Sister Teresa wants prayer for her. Amen. Remember Sister Charlotte, that God will get a hold of her landlord and He'll get her heat fixed. Amen. Because they need heat. Amen. So we prayed and God brought the refrigerator in. He can also, amen, fix the heat. Amen. So let's pray that God will get a hold of that landlord's heart and He'll come this week and fix her heat. Amen. Because I'm telling you, it's cold right now. And it's supposed to be real cold later on tonight. Amen. But she's got some oil heaters that she's using.
If she needs, I've got a bunch of fireplaces.
So, if you're listening, Sister Charlotte, you can get a hold of Sister Bonnie Lynn. Amen. Let's all just stand tonight. Amen. And let's take these needs to the Lord and unspoken requests by the raising of your hand. We don't like, we just stand, amen. We just show the devil, amen. We can do some things different. Amen. Hallelujah, let's just stand, amen. I'm going to ask Brother Wayne to start us out, amen, tonight.
Dear precious Father God, we thank you, God, for your love and your mercy, Father God, for being in my house tonight, Lord. Oh, we just ask you, Father, that you move every heart tonight,
each and every life, God, you heard each and every
request of every soul, Lord, that you went up tonight.
Heavenly Father God, yes, God, you just move on these needs tonight. Lord, as Brother Morris goes to the doctor tomorrow, God, to get those results. Lord, let him get a good report tomorrow, God. Heavenly Father God, we ask it in the name of Jesus, Lord. And God, we pray, God, for those on TikTok tonight, God, that's watching. Lord, that you give their prayer requests in, Lord God. Lord, where they're at tonight, God, it's going into their homes. Hey, Lord God, we pray, God, that something will be said tonight. Lord, I pray for Brother Jackie Stamps tonight and Sister Pat, Lord God. Lord, I pray for Mackenzie and Lynn family, Lord God. Lord, that our mama and daddy, God, comfort them, Lord, that only you can do, God. Lord, the love, Audrey's family, Lord God, Angie Hoskins, Audrey's, Lord. God, be with her and her children, Lord, and her family. Lord, and his family, Lord God. Lord, I pray, God, you be with them, comfort them, Lord. Give them the comfort that they need, Lord. God, we ask, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. God, I pray for those teenagers, family, Lord, out there in Arizona. God, I don't know
who they were, God, that you know the families. God, I pray, God, you comfort them. Lord, comfort them mamas and daddies, Lord God. Oh, God, touch that 14-year-old. God, that's in the hospital out there. Oh, God, I pray, God, you touch Lori. Lord, and her husband, dear God. God, I pray, God, that you would move upon them. Lord, Sister Jeannie Wilson tonight. I pray, God, you touch her body. Lord, be with her, Brother Jimmy, Lord, as they travel upon the highway. Keep your hands upon them. Watch over them. Protect them, Lord. God, we ask in the name of Jesus, Lord. God, I pray for each and every one that's here tonight. Lord, I pray for Cassie and Josh, God. Pray, God, you continue touching Josh, Lord. Lord, I pray, God, for Cassie, Lord God, touch her leg, or her foot, God. Lord, touch little Audrey tonight, God. Lord, take that earache away. Take that fever away. Take that upset stomach away, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for this little young man that was here today, God. Lord, he told his daddy and him, he got healed. That Jesus healed him of that, as the Lord. God, and I pray, God, you grant that little child's faith, God. Oh, God, I ask it in the name of Jesus, Lord. Let his parents see a miracle, God. Oh, hallelujah. Open their eyes, God. That child, Lord God, we ask in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord God, I pray for Sister Bonnie's family tonight. I pray for the church tonight. Lord, I pray for this service. Have your way tonight, God. Lord, I pray for all those that's going to be here Easter Sunday. Lord, I pray, God, that conviction would fall in this place. Lord, the Holy Ghost would come in. Lord, and it would saturate this place. God, we just give you praise. We give you glory. God, touch that pain, Lord God. Lord God, let them get good results, God, back from those tests, Lord. Heavenly Father, God, I praise you. Lord, I pray, God, you have touched Lorraine and Linda, Lord. God, give them the strength that they need. Lord, I ask that God, touch them spiritually, Lord. Oh, God, we just thank you tonight. Lord, I ask you to touch Charity, Lord God. Lord, help her through the rest of this pregnancy, God. God, we ask you right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we give you praise. We give you glory. God, we pray for our first responders, our police officers, our firefighters, our EMT pilots, Lord. God, we ask you to keep your hand upon our soldiers. Lord, we pray for the peace of Jerusalem. We pray for Israel tonight. God, we give you praise. We give you glory. Bless the singers tonight. Bless those that's going to worship tonight. Lord, bless the special singers. God, we ask it in Jesus' precious and holy name.
Michael, amen. Take the ball tonight, amen. Just give what God lays on your heart, and He'll bless you.
Precious Heavenly Father, we come to you this evening, Lord. We ask, please bless this offering. Please bless those that have given, equally those that do not, Lord. Also, dear Lord, we ask you, please use this offering for the uplifting of your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Page 25, He Abides.
Amen. All right. We got a birthday. Amen. Sister Carly Pope. Amen. Cardi. Amen. Today is her birthday. Amen. We're going to sing happy birthday to our California church. Amen. Yeah, she's watching. Amen.
We don't know if she's watching for sure or not, but we're going to say, I mean, she watches it. If she's not watching now, she'll watch after a while.
Someone in need. got a good feeling about this. Yeah.
Everybody's wondering what's up ahead. The storm clouds are gathering, like the Bible said. Now we have a shelter that never will fail. The old ship's about to sail. It wasn't raining when Noah built the ark, so the rush for the door didn't start till it got dark. Don't wait till the judge must give the Lord your heart. It wasn't raining when Noah built the ark, from a babe in a manger to a king.
Brother Morris, won't you just come and start another one, amen, for Brother Ray wants to hear you sing tonight. He,
just sing this for Cassie.
Carry me home. much in a name. Some have fortune, some have fame, but this name means so much more to me. Just a mention of his name from the mountain.
Can face tomorrow.
thankful. Let's give the Lord a big hand clap of praise. Amen. Brother Wayne Chambers. Amen.
Anyways, as I was reading the other day, I come across something, and I couldn't get it out of my mind and off of my heart. Mm-hmm. And the Lord began to deal with me on some things. And I just began to write some of them down and begin to store some of them, Brother Michael, in the back of my mind a little bit. And as things went on, I began to see some things. I'm like, Lord, what are you telling us? What are you telling us? And today, as I was sitting there reading, started seeing some things. Oh, Lord, earlier it was for the church that you're showing me, and it might be for both of us, the church and the sinners both.
Right.
I said, okay, Lord. I still don't understand it, but I'm going to read it. It's a familiar scripture. It's about Hezekiah. Where God extends his life.
Right.
Isaiah 38 and 1, we'll begin reading here. You know, you say, why do y'all stand for the reading of the word? We'll go over and read Nehemiah 8, 4 through 6, it'll tell you everything.
That's
it'll
right.
tell you about the pulpit. It'll tell you how the prophet had men on both sides of him
right.
as he was reading the word of God. As he was reading to them, and the church was amening him there,
right.
agreeing with him. So that's why we stand. And if you want to know why a pulpit's in there, it's only mentioned one time. You
right.
don't read about a stage in the Bible. The
no.
Bible says that he built a pulpit. They built him a pulpit there,
right.
a platform to stand on.
Right.
Right.
That ain't where I want to go tonight. Even though it would hurt some of the churches to hear that.
Right.
It said, in those days was Hezekiah sick unto death.
Right.
And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came unto him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then Hezekiah turned his face to the wall and prayed unto the Lord.
Right.
And said, remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart. And I've done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore.
Mm-hmm.
Then came the word of the Lord to Isaiah, saying, go and say to Hezekiah, thou, thus saith the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer, I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will add unto thy days 15 years.
Right.
And I will deliver thee and this city out of the hand of the king of Syria, and I will defend this city. And this shall be a sign unto thee, for the Lord that is the Lord will do this thing that he has spoken. Behold, I will bring again the shadow of the degrees which has gone down in the sun down Ahaz 10 degrees backwards.
Right.
So the sun returned 10 degrees, by which degrees it was gone down. In other words, God told him, he said, I'm going to give you a sign and show you that I'm going to add them lives back to you. That you, I'm not going to take you out now, but I'm going to give you 15
right.
years. That it don't give you life.
Right.
The Bible says that he told him 15 years. We don't really know how many years we've actually got. But I want to talk to you tonight about setting our house in order.
Amen.
You know, as I was sitting there this afternoon, Sister North, I begin to think about these churches, how they've got the the blackness and how they allow darkness. You know, you look at some of these mega churches, darling, they painted the ceilings black, the walls black, they put neon lights in the ceiling, they put neon lights. You think you was at Ralphie's and they got the thing turned down and you bowl it and you're seeing all these neon lights, colors and different things. But as I was sitting there and I seen it, I said, oh God, help us tonight. He said there's people that are my. I kept seeing witchcraft, Sister Nora, and the thing that I kept seeing about the witchcraft tonight was that the church is playing with witchcraft and people are getting a hold of that Ouija board. That's what kept sticking out to me. A Ouija board. As I was sitting there, I kept seeing it, and I was sitting back there in the back, I began to see an old black silvery snake coming up with that Ouija board. But let me tell you something. I don't know who you are or what you're playing with tonight, but I'm here to tell you tonight, you better get your house in order or God's fixing to pull a plug upon you and hell's gonna be your home. And that snake, which is the devil, is gonna come in and devour you and he's gonna sit back and laugh at you tonight. Hey, I don't know what it is, but somebody tonight, whether it be the church, whether it be a sinner or a backslider, you need to set your house in order. You need to come back to God so he can fill you up and he can bless you once again. Oh, this is what the church world wants to do, what the sinners want to do. They want to stay in darkness. What they need to do is this one thing here, honey. You say, well, what do you got? Well, I ain't going to stick to my eyes. But Jesus said, we need a light. We need a light. The church needs the light. Sinner friend, you need a light. You need a light. See that light in the darkness? We might be in the dark, but we still got the light. We still got the light. We represent Jesus Christ. He's wanting to pull somebody out of the pits of hell tonight. He's wanting to pull them out like, man, they're fixing to slip off right there. Somebody's not comprehending this. They're fixing to slip off into eternal darkness. Whether it be death, poor heaven, they're going to be tormented in their place day and night. My. But he's saying tonight, set your house in order. Set it in order. Yeah. I want my church to set their house in order. I want them to get back to the old path, preaching hell hot. Sin is real, and it's going to take you there. You better put me first. Get all the sins out of your church, heaven. Get those that you got in office. Oh, Lord, here we go. Those you got in office, they shouldn't be there. It's got to sit in order. You've got them in the churches now.
Right.
Practicing all that junk. That's not of God. You've got to tell them. Got them telling them. That it's all right to do this. It's all right to do that.
Right.
But they're not telling you that the things of the world is going to take you to hell. Church, if we hold on to the things of the world, it's going to take us to hell. We need to come clean tonight. We need to set our house in order, Brother Michael, and get everything that's not of God cleaned out, sweep ourselves out, and let him clean us one more time and give us a renewing of the sweet Holy Ghost. As Brother David said, give us a double barrel or a pump shotgun, honey. Overdose of that grain, and then we'll know that when the devil comes a knocking, we can put him under our feet. We can put him over the road. Church is time. We set our house in order. Set a friend on TikTok. You better get rid of that witchcraft that you're practicing.
Amen.
That Ouija board that you're playing with, you're trying to find out about a loved one that's died, and that devil is lying to you. Telling you that they went to heaven. Oh, Lord, all along, when the old heat on them drugs, they split his hell wide open.
That's right. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Oh, Lord. Set your house in order.
Amen.
You say, preacher, how do I do that? Well, Brother David said this morning, get the whole Lord. See, we're in darkness.
Can't see nothing. We're stumbling.
We're absent without the light. We're absent without the light.
See, when we're absent without the light, what present? What present? Evil.
Evil.
Darkness.
It's
present.
What it represents.
It represents that.
That's right.
Sin is in the darkness.
Right.
The devil is in that darkness with you. Hell is in the darkness.
Right.
Depression's in the darkness.
Lord.
Things of this world that'll cause us to stop in our prayer line.
Right.
My, that'll hinder us from doing what God wants us to do. Keeps us from minding the Lord. Keeps us from getting in that prayer time with God like we need to be, like we used to be. That is darkness that we've allowed to creep in, Sister Nora. And it's time we clean our house and we begin to set the thing in order the way God wants it to be set and start listening to Him instead of listening to the flesh. Hey, it's time the church set themselves in order so those that are watching me live stream will understand, hey, them people know what they're talking about. They've had sin in their life. They've got it all cleaned out. They're trying to help me on this thing that I'm going through, and they want to pull me out of a pit of hell tonight, and I need to set my house in order and let the Lord come in and begin to clean me up from the top of my head to the soles of my feet so I can go be in church somewhere where I'm taught the true word of God. When you go to one of these churches, Brother Michael,
yep, Lord.
They're full of black walls,
right.
Black ceilings, neon lights.
Yep. Yep.
You ain't going to worship the Lord because He ain't in the darkness.
Yep.
Right. He ain't in the darkness.
Right.
He ain't there. Oh, you can put on a fake shout. You can be a pretender or anything you want to be. But if the Spirit of the Lord ain't there, honey, what are you doing? You any good to go there? You better find you a place to repent. You better begin to set your house in order. My, I don't know why anybody would want to paint the house of God black. All you're doing is giving place to the devil. Well, you should start giving praise to God Almighty, giving Him the praise. Paint that thing a bright light color of some kind. My. You say, well, we get a lot of people saved. Do you? Do you? How can you? Well, you got darkness in there. You say, well, that monkey just got a little white light in there. Well, just overlook it. Got black in it.
Right.
Black in it. Mm-hmm. Oh. But when you get rid of that, if your church were truly, if the pastors would quit worrying about their deacons and their pocketbooks and then the people just entertain. My. Oh, Lord Jesus. You made the church an entertainment place for the devil, and he's got you so full and so plain warm that it ain't funny anymore. God's getting tired of it. He's going to come in and wipe you and your whole building out and those that's in it that's playing church. It's time you set your house in order tonight.
Amen.
Oh, I ain't done with the light. I'm just tall. My, somebody needs to set their house in order tonight.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to get this thing tonight. They need to set it in order.
Amen.
You say, well, how can I do that? Well, thank you, Jesus. John 1 says this. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. Excuse me. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That same which is in the beginning with God, all things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness,
and the darkness comprehended it not. My, my, my. Yeah. All these churches.
Right.
You know, I'll be honest with you. There's a guy I like, a preacher I like, and he posted a video of his conference or whatever you want to call it that he was at, and it kind of blew my mind. Him being a Pentecostal fireball preacher at this church where it was painted black, black ceiling, black walls, neon lights coming down the walls, hanging out of the ceiling. I thought, man, oh man, what are you doing in that place? You begin to slip a little bit. Maybe you need to set your house on a, well, preacher, you're judging. No, I ain't judging him. I'm just telling you, that kind of church, I don't want no part of it. And if God ever, they ever call me to come preach, they'll throw me out before I even get my first words out. After I read the word, let me tell you something. We need some fireballs like we used to have in the old days. We need to get back to the old path. Start preaching it like it's hotter than it's ever been. That's sin, 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 sin. Hey, it's going to take you to hell whether you're doing this or whether you're doing that. If you're not got out on your sins under the blood, you better get your house in order.
Amen.
Amen. You say, well, preacher, you're talking about us witchcraft people.
Right.
Well, did you know if you rebel, you're witchcraft practicing? Do you know that when you go to one of these soothsayers, one of these palm readers, them fake devil people that's out there to take your money, just tell you something that you want to hear because they ask you all these questions and you're just dumb enough and stupid enough to believe it, but you ain't smart enough to recognize it, that's a trick of the devil.
Amen. Amen.
They say, well, where's it say in the Bible about the, well, read it. From in the Old Testament, it's in the New Testament. Why? Oh. I believe it was Saul. Or Samuel 1. It's in Samuel. When a man was a king, and he went to a soothsayer. Can't think of his name, but you Bible readers know what I'm talking about. He went to a soothsayer, and she caught up a spirit about the grave.
Yes, she did. Yes, yes.
Somebody on TikTok tonight, you're doing some soothsaying. You're doing some witchcraft. You're playing with that Ouija board. You're on your way to hell tonight just as fast as you can get there. But tonight I'm here to tell you there's still time because the light is still in the world and it's there tonight trying to reach in and pull you out and put your foot up on that rock to stay, which is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You say, well, I don't believe that. Well, don't believe it when you get to hell. You remember this old toothless, fat, overweight, out of shape, out of date man telling you that.
Right.
See, the church has lost its true worshipers.
Right. Yeah.
They have lost the true worshipers.
Right.
Because if we really had it, the church, not just listen, I mean the church.
The bride of Christ. Right.
The bride of Christ. Everyone that says they've been blood bought,
right.
Their sins have washed away, they've been made white as snow. That's the church I'm talking about. And yeah, there's some hypocrites in there. They need to set their house in order too. You say, why'd you say? Well, because the hypocrites profess to be a Christian, but their heart's far from it. They're just putting on an act. They're going to church to ease their conscience, and they're going back out doing the things of the world. But God said to tell you the church, tonight you better set your house in order because he's fixing to come in and he's fixing to die and slip off into eternity, lost and undone, as last year Easter egg, and when you get there, you're going to be surprised who you find there.
Right.
So you go over in John a little further there, in verse 4. There was a woman there at the well. There in verse 19, Brother Michael, she said, the woman said unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in the mountains. And you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. And Jesus said unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in the mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father.
That's right.
And he went on to say a little further, Brother Michael. He said, Ye know not what. Ye worship, ye know not what. Sincerely, you worshiping something you don't know nothing about tonight. But you're playing with fire. You're playing with it. And you're as bad thing about it is like you're playing with it. And you're dragging your kids right along right behind you. That's going to be playing with them. And it's going to be playing with it. And you're dragging them off into hell with you. But you better set your house in order tonight. Because hell's on your trail. Death is on your trail, honey. And hell's going to be your final destination. He said, tell them to flee from the wrath that's to come. He said, set your house in order.
Amen.
He said, you worship, you know not what. But this is what he said. We know what we worship. For salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and truth.
Right.
For the Father seeketh such to worship Him.
Right.
Well, y'all awful down on them churches that brings in these fog machines, these strobe lights,
right,
these black walls,
down,
these black ceilings, these neon lights, and all. Well, you know why? Because we know. We know our spirit don't bear witness with our spirit because they're not a true worshiper. They're just there in the flesh trying to get this and that, telling everybody in their congregation and whoever will listen to them, you can do your own thing. You can still go to church. You can still go to heaven. They're telling you once saved, always saved, but you better go and read the back of the book there in Revelation 3 where he tells them, I got something against you. You need to go and do your first works over. He said, because if you're hot, he'd rather you be hot or cold than to be lukewarm, because it's going to spew you out of your mouth if you're lukewarm. Say, Wayne, you're crazy. No. Oh, I ain't done with Mark yet. John 4 yet. I'm fixing to be. It says now. Yes. Let me go back here. Verse 23. But the hour cometh and now. Yes. Now is, Brother Michael, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship Him. Oh my, He's seeking the church to worship Him, the true worshiper. I'm not saying there might be some in there that's been a little misled, and the Lord is dealing with them. Should I go find me another church to go to? Honey, if He's dealing with you today, don't wait, don't talk to your pastor. He'll talk to that man over you, that's your church. He'll talk you out of it going anywhere. He'll tell you it's all right to sin. I know one here in Glasgow, Kentucky, he told one they went, they was lusting after, this man was lusting after other women, and he told everybody lusting, he was all right. I don't know, my God, he has lost his ever-loving mind. The Bible says, if a man looketh upon a woman and lusts upon her, he has committed adultery in his heart. All right, Jesus said that in Matthew 6, I believe it is. That preacher is lost just as last year's Easter egg.
Amen.
He's dragging his flock, those people that go there,
right,
to hell with him.
Right.
Amen.
Verse 24. God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth.
Hallelujah.
Oh my. just love that song. Place talking. Should be. Hallelujah! Preacher! I love that song, sister! I love that song, Brother Moore sang! I love that singing! I love it! Because I feel the power and the presence of God Almighty in the singing! Oh, Jesus. Sinner, I don't know but one way to go, and that's full blast. I'm just going to tell you tonight, I don't care what sin you're doing, you better set your house in order, you better get it all covered under the blood of Jesus, and you better keep it there. You better not go back and pick it back up, because when you do, you'll hang on to the worst demons of what you had in the first place. My.
My.
You say, well, you say you keep talking about this light. You keep calling that light Jesus. Well, that's what it is. It's King Jesus. It's King Jesus. He's still in the saving business. He's still in the healing business. He's still in it all. While there's time, he can set you free. There's goodness in that light.
Yes, there is.
There's goodness, Brother Michael, in that light.
Right.
Amen.
There's knowledge in that light.
Amen.
There's wisdom, there's grace, there's
hope,
and there's God's revelation. You say, what are you talking? Oh, he'll give you a revelation. My, that he'll show you things that you can win and use it to win people to the law of the laws to the Lord, and then he'll get the praise and the glory for it all. Honey, he's good to us. He ain't going to beat us down. He ain't going to drag us down. He's going to lift us up. You say, well, I stumble every now and then, friend. Well, that's all right. The Bible says, though a man falls seven times, so shall he arise. So get up. Quit letting the devil keep you down with his little old toenail. Stand up and say, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. See, when you get truly to the light,
right.
Come here, Brother Michael. Say, well, y'all use that boy a lot.
That's all right. Use it with it.
See? Brother Michael, did you repent of all of your sins?
Nothing, Lord.
You sure? You just prayed. You didn't see your sins, did you? No. You sure?
You sure? Yes, you did.
Yeah. You didn't feel nothing come to your body?
No.
Well, you need to get back to your body.
Are you sure
now? I'm
not
really
sure.
See, that's the way it is.
Yeah,
that's the way it is. And you say no. The preacher will tell him, yeah, you're saved.
Right.
Or he'll say, shake my hand. Shake the preacher's hand. Everything's all right. We just wrote you. God just wrote your name down in the book of life. That's a bunch of hogwash that the devil is telling people tonight. He's saying, I'm telling you, just like I'm telling the preacher tonight, you better get everything under the blood. You better begin to set your house in order. God's getting tired of this garbage that you're preaching, that you're teaching, and you're leading his sheep, his precious sheep, to the devil's hell where he don't want them to go, but yet you're too vulnerable to follow after the devil. You don't know which way's up. You don't know which way's down. You don't know which way's sideways because you're chasing after the devil. You're getting your messages from online. You're getting them from your organization. They send them to you, as Brother David said this morning, via email or through the mail. If you are truly a man of God, been anointed and called by God to preach the gospel, honey, your message will come from on high. You won't need some stiff-necked man said or woman sending headquarters typing out what you need to say to the people in your organization or in your church.
Right.
Blessed
Lord.
organization that you're in, and they're doing that, best thing advice I can give you is tell them we're pulling out. We don't want no more part of you. God give us a new revelation. He said for us to seek out the old path and to walk therein, and to trust in Him, and to set our house in order. In order for us to set our house in order, we're going to have to pull out the organization and quit getting our messages from you and start getting them from God, down on our knees and out of a book or my mind that was written by the men of old, and let us begin to talk and to preach what God wants us to do. See, when you really come, I can't remember what I said this morning. He'll make everything visible to us.
That's right.
He'll open our eyes that we have allowed the devil to shut. See, when He opens our eyes, we see bright, we see more clear.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
We're no longer heavy to the sins and the cares of this world. We're no longer burdened down. We're no more troubled.
Right.
But we can take our troubles to the Lord. We don't have to let them drag us down, put a pack on our back, Brother Michael, and pull the rocks. Too many church members do today, when all they've got to do is just drop that pack and say, God, I'm dropping my burdens here. You see the load that I'm carrying for my family. You see the load that I'm carrying for my loved ones, for my co-workers, for my friends, those that's asking us to pray. Lord, you see the load that I'm carrying. What I'm praying for, God, you know what they have need of. God, you move on them. Not nothing I can do, God. I'm just bringing it to you on their behalf because they asked me to. I'm not going to carry their burdens, Lord. I'm going to bring them to you. Now you open their eyes up and show them, Lord, that's what they need to do. They need to bring their burdens to you and drop them at your feet.
Amen.
And when you do that, you won't have to worry about them. See, I'm going to tell you something. These last few weeks, y'all don't know this. Connie don't know this. But I've been battling. My body is hurting, okay? I've been hurting for over a month now. Now my whole left side, into my foot. Thank God I finally got some rest the last 2 nights without any pain except for the bottom of my foot. And yeah, I still wake up every now and it's hurt, and I had to get up and shake that off and walk a little bit on it, and then I can go back to bed. Before, I couldn't do that. I just talk and turn and get aggravated. But I'm glad I kept holding on, even though I was going through some things. Hey, I didn't lose sight of the light. I was near darkness and the dead. I even got to the point I couldn't hardly walk, Brother Michael. I got up here in the middle of the night. My.
Yep, Lord.
I cried. I said, God, you see the pain I'm in. You see my foot. I can't even put it down without it hurting. I said, I can't even put it down. I said, God, I'm just begging you to touch it. I'm begging you to touch it. I'm begging you, Lord, touch it so I can walk and get out of this pain. And I was in that pain for almost 30 days.
Right.
It still acts up now and then, but not like it did then. And I was going through some other things besides that. I've had some spiritual mind going, spiritual warfare going on in the mind. The devil fighting me with this, fighting me with that, telling me this and telling me that. You might as well give up. You might as well just quit. You ain't preaching no words. You ain't being asked to preach at the church. Well, I understood that. God understood that because I was in some pain, folks. I do good to walk through the house without limping. But some of the spiritual things that was going through my mind from the devil, honey, oh my, I was hurting so bad, Sister Darlene. The devil said, won't you just get that gun up where you've got it at? And go ahead and shoot yourself. Get out of this pain. I said, devil. I said, you stupid idiot. That's what I said. want to leave this pain. To come there and be in pain. I said, this pain's going to leave me someday. But that pain's going to last forever.
Amen.
See, you've got to be wise as a serpent.
Amen.
And harmless as a dove. You got to recognize that old slew-foot, lying, black snake thing that's coming after the church like he's never had before. And center friend, he's after you. He's on your heel. He's fixing to take and fixing to take a bite of you if you don't watch it, because you're playing in that, you're living in that darkness. You're playing with things that he's teaching, that he's got that witchcraft in. And he's fixing to bite you. And once he bites you, it's over for you. Once he bites you real good, he's got you hooked. All these sins, you'll be into satanic junk like you've never been before. You'll be into that where Satan worshiping and everything else and saying God's not real. But one day after a while, those people are going to realize, hey, he is real. He is real, because you're going to be in hell burning, and the devil's going to be laughing at you, and you're going to see him sitting on the throne, and you're going to see Jesus on the right hand of him.
Amen.
And you're going to remember that time when the Lord dealt with you, and you laughed at his face, and you rejected him.
Help him, Lord.
You better get your house in order. You better clean your house. You better sweep it. You better vacuum it. You better mop that thing clean. You better allow God to come in and give you a cleaning like you've never had before. It wasn't the old Lord Jesus. Some of the church world needs a good old laxative. They need a good holy dose of laxative like it's never had before. I remember Tucker when we lived out in the country. He called me. He said, Wayne, I said, yeah. He said, I give my life back to the Lord. I said, well, praise the Lord. He said, I said, where are you at? He said, I'm in the bathroom on my throne. Yep. Using the bathroom. I said, oh, so you got a double cleanser.
Lord.
I said, the Lord moved on you twice.
Yep.
He touched you physically, and he touched you spiritually.
Yep.
He said, I never thought about that yet. Yep. These mega churches. These other people going to these churches, that's believing the hogwash is falling from that man's lips or woman. Probably man, because most of them don't believe in women.
Right.
Preachers.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
I made some mad the other day. Oh well, I'll get over it.
Yep, Lord.
That's right.
I told him three things. I said, one, you don't believe the Bible. Two, you're ignorant and unlearned. Or three, you just stuck in tradition. And I believe it's number three. More than it is anything else.
Yeah.
But anyways, that was a freak. Church, this goes for me too. We need to serve a house in order. We need to keep it in order. We need to keep our house in order. We need to set it up and be like Joshua. And say, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. This night, poor sinner friend, you on earth playing with witchcraft, you can say, Lord, I want that light, and I want to set my house in order. I want to be like Joshua and set my house in order, and I want to serve you.
Amen.
What better way to start March the 20th and end March the 19th with knowing that Jesus is coming to your life. Knowing that he set you free of your darkness. Knowing, church, that he cleaned you up. That he put your foot back on that rock to stay. Knowing that he swept all your sins under the blood. My. Oh, I want to read this. I want to tell you what a black snake means. It means two things. Means one or two things. See, I told you I sinned two things back there. One of the two things is death.
Yep.
A black snake represents death.
Right.
Oh, but can I tell you something else? It also represents a rebirth. TikTok, you need a rebirth tonight. Center, you need a rebirth. Church, you need a rebirth tonight. You need a renewing of the sweet Holy Ghost. You need a renewing in your soul. You need to lay down your sins of the curse of the world center on TikTok and Facebook, big old lie. You need to lay all your sin away and pick up that cross and follow Jesus and get that rebirth. Be refreshed. Be renewed from on high with new power, and you can put the enemy under your feet, and you can keep on marching on for Jesus like you never marched before. You can keep on stepping high. You can talk, dance on your toe. You can talk, tiptoe through the tulips with it all you want to, honey, because your name is written in that Lamb's Book of Life, and you can let the world know, hey, my main man is Jesus. He died for me, and he came to set me free, but not only me, whosoever will. He said, let him come. Can I introduce you? Can I tell you about this man, Jesus? Can I tell you about what he can do for you? Can I tell you what he can do for you? What he done for me? Oh, my. He'll give you a rebirth tonight.
Right?
Saying, amen. amen. I was seeing a church the other night, amen. The whole church is black. Everything I'm talking is just like blacked out. And they paint their walls so pitch black, so dark. And they say, well, that helps the sound. It makes the sound better. Well, see, you read the Bible says that Satan was over the music. So if he was over the music, he was over the sound. Amen, there's a sound wave. That's why I got these speakers the way I got them, because the sound wave meets in the middle. But see, they got theirs all around the whole auditorium, the way they built them, Brother Michael, so the sound will override the... They're hearing the sound of the music instead of hearing the sound of God. Amen. They have it so loud sometimes in there that they just like their scream. See, there's a church here in Glasgow. I ain't going to name the name. But there's a church here in Glasgow. They scream gospel. You ever heard of scream gospel? They scream gospel songs. They don't sing them. They scream them. It's called scream gospel. One of the big mega churches. Amen? Listen. Amen. I read in my Bible, the Bible said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Right.
Amen. And the Spirit of God is moving in the houses of the Lord. It lets God move. Amen. But the light cannot comprehend. The darkness can't comprehend the light. Satan don't like Jesus. He don't like the light. And if he can cause the sanctuaries to be dark, then where's the light? Amen. Where's the light at?
Right.
It ain't in, like Brother Wayne said, it ain't in them neon lights. It ain't in them flashing lights. And it ain't in all that stuff. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Amen. He's the light. Sister Jackie, and the only thing that we can do, amen, is keep ourselves ready to go be with Jesus. Amen. Sister Jackie. Stand in prayer for Hannah's mom. Hannah, one of the ladies on TikTok. Amen. Y'all come on up here, amen. Let's pray for Sister Jackie.
That's why he only attacks you when you're asleep.
Amen.
Jackie, to stand in prayer for Elizabeth Winteringer's aunt. If if I recall what she said a little bit ago, I think she said they had called hospice in for her. I think it was what she said. She asked for.
Come on back up here, Sister Jackson.
Elizabeth Windturner's aunt. Her aunt, they called hospice in and they say she don't have long. She asked for her to send in therapy.
Bless you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we anoint Sister Jackie and Lord Elizabeth Ventura's aunt. Heavenly Father, you know, God, Lord, that you are the healer. Lord, that we know, God, that our ways are not your ways. Lord God, if it's our time to go, Lord, that God, Lord, God, go all the way to Texas tonight. God, and touch her, God. We ask right now. God, in the name of Jesus, your will to be done, Lord. God, your will to be done in this, God. We ask you right now. God, this other one on TikTok tonight. Heavenly Father, God, you see who she is, Lord. God, if you see that need tonight, Heavenly Father, God, we ask you to reach down and touch it, Lord. God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. You're doing miracles, God. You're doing signs and wonders tonight. Somebody else. Yes, amen. Somebody else. Else. I'm going to ask Sister Jackie, Sister Connie, and Sister Bonnie, amen, to pray over our prayer box. We're going to tell our live stream audience, we appreciate y'all. We love you. TikTok, Big O Live, Facebook Live, we love you. We appreciate you. Thank you for every time you tune us in, amen, and you watch us. Amen. We're just preaching the Word of God, amen. We're not adding nothing to it. We're just preaching what the Word says, amen, and it's up to you if you want to live it. We can't make you live it. But it's up to you if you want to live it. Amen. But we appreciate you. We love you. We ask you please tune us back in Thursday night, Lord's will. Amen. We'll be here. Amen. Have a church. Amen. May God bless you from He's Alive Community Church is our prayers.